Hey, it's your boy Bobby Beach. I want to talk about a subject that comes to mind, and that is Goku and Vegeta as dads, husbands, and men. So we're going to talk about Goku and Vegeta in that way, in terms of, you know, how they are. Now, Goku and Vegeta are pretty good guys when it comes down to it. And not only that, you know, when you sit back and we watch, you know, Dragon Ball, and all of us, we love it as much as we possibly can. The whole thing is that when it comes down to it, there's a lot more going on there than the whole, you know, fighting and the power-ups and, you know, all of that stuff of that nature. We're talking about not just that. We're talking about basically characters that are strong and they show us different ways about them. Dragon Ball is, of course, about the fighting and all the powers and everything, but then there's more to it. There's comedy to it, and there's just the fact that the people inside of the show are very good people. And when it comes down to it, Goku and Vegeta are very good people. Now, Goku and Vegeta, basically when it comes down to it, they are awesome characters. We love them. They are pretty much the guys of the whole Dragon Ball series. They're the main characters. Now, Vegeta was not a part of Dragon Ball, but he's been there since Dragon Ball Z. And from Dragon Ball Z on, he is truly one of the main characters, pretty much under Goku. If Goku was not the main character, Vegeta would be the one who's the main character. Now, these guys are pretty much great dudes in their own right. And basically, when it comes down to it, this is what I'm going to say here with them. Basically, them as dads. Now, Goku gets this whole thing where everyone says that he is a bad dad. Goku's not a bad dad. Goku is always around no matter what. He's always, you know, he's a dad who was there. He helped raise Gohan. A lot of people don't understand that. Goku was there right there at the very beginning with Gohan. As a matter of fact, the whole thing is that him coming after Raditz was because Raditz took Gohan with him, and he came after Raditz for Gohan. Likewise, when Goku came back, he came back to protect Gohan. Likewise, he went all the way to Namek to protect Gohan, and even came back to Earth, and he believed in Gohan more than anybody. As a matter of fact, he was when he saw Gohan and he trained with Gohan in the Room of Spirit and Time, he saw the power inside of his son. And not only that, he believed in his son and said, my son is the one who's going to pretty much look out for us. He's the one who's going to save us. My son has the power. And guess what? He was not wrong, because Gohan saved all of them. And not only that, we're going to talk about the fact that when we get into the Buu saga, he still believed in Gohan, even though Gohan was not where he needed to be. Gohan was not training like how he was. Gohan was just doing everything he could in terms of his own life. And Goku didn't really came at his son about nothing. He was just pretty much saying, okay, my son is still powerful. He just hasn't been training and all things along those nature. Now, not only that, we're going to talk about even, let's go into Super Territory. When we go into Super Territory, you know, he looks at Gohan as Gohan being who he is. You know, Gohan turned out to be a businessman. He turned out to be a guy, you know, like he's out there. He's exceeded things. He's a very smart human being. His son has gone on to become that kind of person. And not only that, he doesn't say anything about him. Now, there's times where he does encounter Gohan and he wants Gohan to be that warrior, that fighter and things of that nature. But at the end of the day, Gohan is who Gohan is when it comes down to it, in terms of Gohan is his own person. He doesn't really come ahead his son about being something he wants him to be, but rather he's like, okay, you know, that's Gohan. Gohan does what he has to. And there's times, like, for example, when Gohan showed up to train with Goku and the whole Great Saiyan Man outfit, there was that moment of heat to the point that he was fighting his son and pushing him to as far as he could. And then the moment when Gohan realized, hey, I need to come back to being the warrior I need to be, he challenges father. So those are some of the great father and son moments that Goku have. And likewise with Goten, he didn't even know about Goten. When he came back and saw Goten, he took right to his son. Not only that, let's talk about the fact that he spends all his time with Goten. Like, when we're in Super, Goku is always around Goten. So, I mean, I'm like, come on, man. Stop coming at Goku about that. Stop, you know, stop all that jump by Goku's not a good dad, because the dude is a good dad. Likewise, Vegeta. Vegeta is a good dad. I mean, hell, we all know that. For example, when Trunks was first born, he was like, whatever, I'm not hearing that. But now, Vegeta has changed into this person. Well, Vegeta is there with his family. He's a family guy. He's always around Trunks. He's always around Bulla. The dude loves his kids. He's always around them no matter what. So there's really no knocking Vegeta on being that awesome parent, because he is, you know, that good parent. And not only that, he's probably the best father in Dragon Ball series. Not knocking Piccolo either. But basically, Vegeta raised the young Trunks. He's raising Bulla and future Trunks, who is pretty much, he never had Vegeta in his timeline, but Vegeta looks out for him. And then there's Kaba. Vegeta looks out for Kaba too. So technically, Vegeta's looking out for many children. So he's like one of the most awesome dads in the series. Now let's talk about them as husbands. Goku, as a husband, Goku loves Chi-Chi. At the end of the day, Goku did not marry Chi-Chi because it was like, okay, I love you, I want to be with you. It was more of a situation where he thought marriage was food. He ended up with her, and he hasn't left her since. As a matter of fact, they're still together. They're always around one another. Whenever Goku, you know, is there, and she's there. She loves Goku, the girl. I mean, she talks her junk all the time. She runs her mouth. But at the end of the day, she loves Goku, and Goku absolutely loves her. You don't see Goku leaving, do you? You don't see him cheating or anything. And yeah, he talked that junk about not understanding certain things. But the guy got two kids. How in the hell you don't understand something if you got Gohan and you got Goten? Man, come on. Goku knows what's going on. I mean, put like this right here. Goku knows about sex, okay? And then there's Vegeta. Vegeta and Bulma. Oh, my goodness. Vegeta and Bulma have a relationship where, of course, they talk junk. They're coming at one another, but these two absolutely love each other. And they do everything they can to make sure that they're around each other point blank, period. Vegeta is a home guy. He's not one of those guys who goes out hanging out and tripping and all that messing on those nature. No, he's there with them. He's always training around them. Sometimes, okay, of course, he does leave and he goes train and do those other things, just like Goku. But the whole thing is that, you know, they're always at home. These guys love being around, you know, they love being around their families, their wives. You know, they love being around them. So these are very faithful guys. Both of them very faithful. They're not cheating on their wives. They're not doing nothing stupid along those lines. So they're pretty good in that department. So they're pretty good. You know, they're good husbands. Now, let's talk about them as men. When it comes down to Goku and Vegeta as men, Goku is one of the most awesome characters to ever be around. He's truly a good guy. He is what the way he is. He's focused. He's the type that's, you know, good energy, love to make people laugh. He acts, I put it like this, Goku's not dumb. And let's just all be real about it. We know Goku is not dumb. Goku just acts dumb a lot. But the whole thing is he's very smart. He's not used to a lot of stuff that's up in the world in terms of like how things work, in terms of, and you know, how things is with, you know, the hospital, with the law and with the way things run, because he's mainly been raised in the country. He still lives in the country. Vegeta may be up on game more than Goku is, but Vegeta really doesn't mess with too many people like that on that nature. In terms of them as men, they are pretty good men. They fight. They'll do whatever it takes to make sure everything is fine for people. They're true to one another. In terms of, like, how can I put this? If they are with you or they got your back, Goku and Vegeta are there. They're your friends. They're not going to turn on you. They're just good men. You know, they push as far as they can. They go as hard as they can. They are always out there, you know, to fight, to make sure everything is all right for everybody. So the whole thing is with them. As men, these are awesome men. Now, the thing is that with Goku and Vegeta, basically, these are two guys that will fight. They'll go to war. They'll make sure everybody is fine. They're willing to die to make sure everybody is fine. They stand by their beliefs no matter what. Goku is more open-hearted. He'll go, he'll fight, he'll do whatever it takes to make sure everybody is fine. Vegeta, on the other hand, is a little more selfish. And you know, the whole thing is, when I was a kid, I was like, Goku's the admired thing because I had the whole Christ thing with Goku. Goku acted like a Christ figure type of person. Vegeta act like a straight up dude, like, you know, I don't give a damn. Now, as a grown man, I understand Vegeta more. Because Vegeta just looks at things like, okay, these people are like this and these people are like that. They BS and they be BSing most of the time. So I'm going to show you who I am. And I think that's the reason why Vegeta acts the way he acts, where Goku is more open, more, you know, people can betray him. People can hurt him, try to take advantage of him because of how he is. He's not dumb now. He's up on game too, but Vegeta is more alert, more aware, if I had to be honest with you. But they're both, like I said, they're pretty good men. And, these are some awesome guys. And the thing is, they're very, very awesome characters. And we read their adventures all the time. We check them out and they do a lot. And the whole thing is this, there's a lot going on there. You know, we love the fights. We love the power ups, you know, all those things along those natures. But these are just technically very good guys and they're good dads. They are good husbands and they're just good men in general. And they have affected my life growing up because, I mean, at the end of the day, I've been watching Dragon Ball for over 20 something years and I'm here talking about Dragon Ball, as a matter of fact. So the whole thing is, when it comes down to it, is that Goku and Vegeta really changed my life. If anything, Goku was the one who made me into who I am when I was growing up. Vegeta, Vegeta, I understood him better as an adult. So it's like now the whole thing is that when it comes down to these two, they really affected my life, made me into the man I am today. And I'm pretty happy about that. But yeah, when it comes down to it, we're going to talk about Goku and Vegeta as men. You know, they're just good people in general. We're going to, you know, the, of course, course they got the power-ups. Of course they got the fights. Of course all those things. But they are just good men in general. And I can say that they have affected my life. And to the point that I believe, I just want to say, I think I'm a good guy. So, but at the end of the day, they have affected my life. But I just want to say, it's your boy, Bobby B's here. I just want to say much love, much respect. I just want to say go ahead and subscribe. Check out my other Dragon Ball content. Like this video. And I just want to say much love, much respect. Hold it down and one. Hey, it's your boy Bobby B's here. I want to talk about a subject that comes to mind. And that is...